Hello everybody. My name is Laurent and today I'm going to introduce you to the Zebra Print Service application that you can find on the Play Store. It has been developed by Thunderlight Software and it is an Android print service for Zebra technology, ZPL and even direct PDF based printers. It supports USB printer, Bluetooth and network connections. So let's go directly to what I want to show you. Here for this demonstration, I will start with my corporate phone, that is a Pixel 3, and with the ZQ 320 that has been set up to work with Bluetooth and Wi-Fi connection. So what the Zebra Print Service allows me to do is, for example, is I'm on Chrome. I have opened the Zebra front page, and here it's in French. I can hit the menu here, and I have sharing capabilities. And here it's imprimé, which means print. And here, as you can see, it has detected my ZQ 320, and it has adapted all the preview to the size of my media, which is pretty small, 4 inches. It's very small, and but there are 12 pages, so I'm not going to print all these pages, only the first one. So there, I will hit the print button, and if you check it out, you will see the Bluetooth icon blinking, which means that data are actually being transferred to the printer. And once it will stop blinking, it means that the PDF, the data are inside the printer and processed by it, and we have our first page. So as you can see, it's pretty nice dithered for a thermal printer, but I've just print from Chrome, and it means that if you're on any application that implement the sharing to printer capability, for example Word or Excel or Google Chrome, can print on any ZPL based printer, Zebra printer, or direct PDF enabled printers, which can be pretty convenient. Even if you are a developer, you can even stop using the Link-OS SDK, for example, to implement your printer and just implement the sharing capability with printing feature, and everything will work flawlessly. So for this demonstration, I started with a personal device to work to with a corporate device, which is a managed device running on Android 11, to show you that it works on every Android device. To continue, now I will start to show you how to install it and how to set up the application to make it work on your device. I will use a TC52 running the latest version of Android 10 for the manual installation, and I will use a TC56 to show you how to how you can use an EMM that implement the Google Enterprise API, the managed configuration. In fact, every EMM that implements the managed configuration can set up remotely the Zebra Print Service, and I will show you it later. So first step is how to get what I showed you on my Pixel 3. Let's open Visor. Okay. So the first step is to go to the Play Store. Then you look for the Zebra Print Service. Okay, Thunderlight Software, Zebra Print Service, this is the one we are looking for. So we are going to install it. Yeah, done. That was pretty fast. Okay, so if you take a look At the description, you will see please enable location permission to allow the discovery of devices. So how to allow the permission for the Zebra Print service? You have to open the setting of your device and you have to look for print, because you are looking right now for print services, because it's a print service. In your own, it's print here because the locale of this device is in English. On a French device, for example, the Pixel 3, it was impression. You have to look for the translation of print in your own language to find this entry in the menu, in the settings. So you click on it, and as you can see, we have a default print service, which is the one that you can use to save as PDF file, and we have the Zebra print service. So we will click on it, and here on this page, you will see a menu on the right top of the screen. And this is in this menu, you have Add Printer and Settings. We need to grant the permission before being able to add printers. So we go to settings, and here you have this pink permissions label and this small description that told you to click here to enable the permission. Let's go for it. Let's allow all the permissions, and job's done. Permission granted. So we can go back here and we can go to our add printer menu. So now it will start a discovery, a Bluetooth discovery, and then a network discovery. And that's it. We have our two printers. I mean, this is the same printer, but since it has been set up to be available as a network one and as a Wi-Fi one, it is detected as two ways, two printers, but this is the same one. But for the fun, we will say that we are in the lobby, and this is my lobby, ZQ320. My media size will be 315, and the height will be, for example, 4. And I submit. Okay, I still have the network printer. So this one will be my kitchen printer. This is perfectly convenient to print my grocery list. Not sure my job, my manager will appreciate it, but let's say this is my kitchen ZQ320, and I submit. Okay, now we have two printers in the print service. So let's go back to the launcher and let's open Google Chrome. And there we are in the front page of Zebra. We can hit share, and here we have the famous print, not impression like on my Pixel 3. And as you can see, badam, it has generated a preview that is adapted to the media size that we have set up here. If I go to the kitchen ZQ, the preview will be different. I will only have 7 pages because I have a different media in the kitchen ZQ. It is a 6 inches in height media. But for this one, I'm using the lobby one because I don't have a lot of paper here at home. So let's hit the print button, and no, we don't hit the, did we? No, we didn't. Okay. Why? Because I don't want to print all the 11 pages. I just want to print the one-to-one. This is a full live session. I want you to see what you see is what you get. So fortunately, I didn't hit OK on this button. So what is this pop-up? If you have already installed a print service on any Android device, for example, on my corporate one, I have installed the Canon print service that allows me to print directly on my personal Canon printer. The first time I used this service, I had this screen. I don't know how the Canon print service works, but as far as I know, the Zebra print service doesn't send anything outside of your device. The communication is done directly between the device and the printer without going anywhere outside in the world. So if you are paranoid about this, or if you want to participate, it is an open source initiative, so you can directly go to the Thunderlight Software GitHub and check it out for yourself, and you will see that it does not go outside of just your printer and just your phone. So Bluetooth should be blinking right now. We are waiting for, yeah, it's still blinking, sending the data. Should have used the Wi-Fi one because it's usually faster. And we have it. We have the front page printed. Job's done. So this is a manual way to use the Zebra print service. Now I'm going to show you how to use the Google Enterprise Managed Configuration API to set up the Zebra print service from any EMM that implements these APIs. And I will do it on a TC56. So this TC56 is a, as you can see here, this device is managed by your organization. I am the organization. So, what I will show you how to set up the Zebra print service using the Wheezy EMM, EMM. Why? Because it's a pretty simple EMM to use, very simple to use. It has all the latest Google Enterprise API implemented, as well as specific Zebra APIs, which are, for example, the Zebra Lifeguard over the air implementation, which will allow you to push your Zebra Lifeguard patch monthly on your devices without any hassle. And it implements all the Android Enterprise API. And as I said before, you will see it's pretty easy to use. So the first thing I have to use on this EMM, and I think it will be almost the same on the other EMM, I mean in terms of use case. So I hope you will be able to translate this in the EMM you are actually using. So I have to, in the Wheezy EMM, I have to declare a public application as a managed application by my company. So the first thing I do is go to application management, public application, and then I'm looking for the Zebra print service. Okay, Thunderlight Software. It's the right one. Do you want to manage this application for your enterprise? Yes, it's already managed. Live effect. I did it just before, but I want to show you the whole. Since I want to show you the whole process, I will remove it and I will remanage it. Live session, sorry. Okay. Job's done has been added to the applications. If I go there, I can check it out. And if I hit here, I will be redirected to the Play Store page of the application. So it's the right one. Now, on WYSIWYGS with profile, you define a profile, and after that, you enroll all your devices to this profile. And every time you make a change on the profile, it's automatically pushed back on your device. As we are actually, as I want to show you how to use the managed configuration, not necessarily how to use with EMM, I have already prepared a profile for my tests. So here I've opened my profile and I go to applications. As you can see, I already have Visor installed on the device, And this is why I can access to it and show it to you right now. So I will only have to add an application. I look for something with print, Zebra Print Service. Oh, I check the small cross and put OK. OK, there we are. This application will be first installed. If you plan to use the application the same way that I did on the TC57 and on my own personal device, which means allowing your user to discover directly the printers, you will just have to set permissions from your EMM. All the EMM can do that, so you just have to go to the permission and grant any permission you want to grant to allow your user to access to a discovery. For example, you won't grant the Wi-Fi state if you want your, and you will grant the Bluetooth settings as well as the precise location if you want to get your user, if you want your user to be able to discover only Bluetooth printers, and you can stop Bluetooth settings if you want to your user to discover only Wi-Fi printers. It's up to you, but this is not what I want to show you right now. What I want to show you is a very, very interesting API of Google Enterprise, which is Android Enterprise, sorry, which is the managed configuration. Managed configuration is really easy to use. It allows you to set up any application that implements it directly from any EMM that support this API. For example, on the Google on the Zebra Print service, we have the possibility to define the list of printers to set up on the device. This will be a static list, which means that your user will only have access to this list when it is when you have decided to manage it. If you let it without nothing, it will do nothing. But if you put a list of printer here, the list on the device will be always overwritten by what you have set up on your EMM. So it's a way of predefining all the printers without letting your user change things or add new printers or things that could disrupt your production. So we can set a friendly name for the printer, for example, still the Lobby printer, and a description, printer located in the lobby. We can say that this one is a Bluetooth printer. Here we need the address of the printer. I think I have it somewhere here. Yeah, there we are. I will show you what this file is later. I don't need a printer port because it is only for Wi-Fi, for networked printer, for the French accent. And the resolution is 203 dpi. So you may ask me, where do I find this information? So a little trick, you go to the zebra.com website, you look for your printer, for instance here the ZQ300 series, and you look for the spec sheet. You open the spec sheet, and at the bottom of the spec sheet you will see the printer specification. So let's make it a little bit larger, and if you take a look here, resolution 303 dpi. That's it, that's where you get it. And on mine, I used a label that has the maximum size of the media width. And here it's 3.15. That's where I get the number I entered inside the configuration. So you can define the paper unit size in centimeters or inches, depending if you are, if you like metric system or whatever system you want to use. And here I can put, for example, 5. If I submit this configuration, I will have this printer directly, it will appear directly in my list. But what I want to show you is on WiseEye with EMM, you can do an export and an import, which means that you can prepare a whole configuration and export it to, for example, do some like source control, so which allows you to track in time what configuration you have put on your printers, or it allows you to to directly manually add lists of printer. I will show it to you later. So now I'm just importing this file and I have three printers predefined. So the first one is the logistic one in Bluetooth, which is a printer available in the location one of the logistic office. There we have the logistic in location two, and very original logistic in location 3. This one is a network one. She has an address, she has a printer port. It's by default 9100 if you haven't changed anything on your configuration. If you have changed something on your printer configuration, you must know what port it is. And here I was pretty sure I made a mistake. It's 203 and not, and I have the same here too. Let's check all the thing. That's why tracking your configuration can be interesting, because after that, with the JSON file, you can use tools like WinDiff to check the difference between two configuration and find errors. So right now I made a managed configuration. I put my application as first installed, so I will save my profile. Okay, profile updated. So I will go back to Visor and I will check it out on my device. Oh, nice. Zipra Print Service is now installing. Zipra Print Service successfully installed. So what do we have? Let's check it out. I open Chrome. I will go back to the Zipra. Oh, it's easier with the keyboard. Zipra.com. This time it's in French. Okay, I will go there, share, print, and look at this. I have three printers, three different printers. Wi-Fi, logistic, on Bluetooth. Pretty neat. So let's try it out. Oh, paper size 10 inches. Oh my god, it will be very, very big. Why is the printer not available? No, this one won't be available. It doesn't exist. Those are fake printers. Maybe the 3 is yeah. One of them is a fake one. I don't remember which one. So let's switch it back to the Bluetooth because one of them is not configured correctly. So let's switch back to the Bluetooth and let's check it out. Let's print only. Oh, we have a 10. Yeah, let's print only the first page. And let's hit the print button. Same pop-up. Let's hit OK. Let's check it out on the printer. And yeah, here we go. Bluetooth is blinking. And now it's processing. And now it's printing. Big one. Let's check something. Maybe My printer is not has not. I think the reason why I couldn't access to the printer is maybe because the IP address. I don't have. It's a dynamic dynamic address. I don't have a static address on this printer, so I think it's not the actual IP of the printers because it's a file I made before. So this is not relevant. So as you see, I showed you today the Zebra print service that will allow you to print anything from any printers. And I hope you enjoyed it. I hope that you learned how to use this software, and I hope that you will use it on your device because I think it's a pretty nice piece of software that can be very useful when you are using Chrome with web application, for example, or even for your developments. So I say bye bye, and you can put some comments if you want. You can like this video if you want, and you can even subscribe. I don't know if there if it is a channel or something. This is my first YouTube video, so do the thing you want to do. But I will push more video in the future. So bye bye, and have fun with Zebra printers.